another episode of Alumni Talks brought to you by Shivajirao Jhonle College of Engineering and its IEEE student branch. I would like to begin with thanking our management, our Principal Sir, Dr. J.W. Bakil, for his encouragement, Professor P.R. Rodge and Dr. Uttara Bogte for their constant support. Data is the new oil. We have heard this so many times. Why? Because an estimated 2.5 quintillion bytes of data is generated daily on an average. The order of 10 to the power 18. That is a huge amount of data. When something is available in such humongous amount, it's more than sensible to make it a resource. And that's what we have done. We are continuously trying to use the data in the best way possible. Data science related courses are trending everywhere. Everyone is trying to learn the tools and techniques about it. But wouldn't it be more exciting if we came to know the actual how of the data? You've got you covered. And that's what our speaker for today is going to tell you. The real journey of data. A case study of data in an enterprise. Let's welcome our speaker for the episode, Mr. Abhishek Sarda, a computer engineer currently working as manager in Cape Gemini, India. Welcome, sir. We are looking forward to your session. The screen is all yours.
Sorry. Thank you for inviting me up here. I am really very excited to share some information that I have with me and probably could be useful to you all. So I believe the screen sharing is on and we can start with my presentation. Shruvi, if you can confirm me that.
Your screen sharing isn't there.
Yeah, it's on.
It's on.
Okay, yeah, it's on.
All right. So onto your screen, we would be talking all about data. Now, the data, this I personally call it as the new gold. So what happens? We plan to go through this session is, what is data? How is this processed? What is the complete life cycle basically? And how is it important to make any decisions up here? Okay, and just because this is a student council, I like to keep myself a bit casual, so do not mind having these sessions casual, but the main agenda up here is that you get the content of it and you can make most out of it, plus it is a little understandable because when you go casual, the things are a little more understanding. So I'll start right away with my introduction up here. So my name is Abhishek Sarda, as has got introduced, and I am a computer engineer from 2010 batch pass out. So, and I roughly have 10 years of experience in insight and data. So insight and data, which means I have some data and then how do I use this and what kind of visualizations can be used for this. And currently I'm working with Capgemini India as a manager. So what I'll do is I'll just try to keep these sessions a more interactive so you all can speak or raise your questions whensoever you feel like. Okay, so these are those kind of sessions where the interaction is much more important, but again I'll keep it to me most of the time. So the first question, what is data? Okay. So data, I would personally call data as anything which gives me, which makes more of a meaningful information. What do you mean by meaningful information? So information, you have some data, you can use that, but probably at this stage, we would not discuss how do you use that. For now, we'll restrict the things as anything which is meaningful is an information to me. Okay. And what about the things which are not meaningful to me? उनकी सिर्फ फेक न्यूज बनती है या फिर वो मीम्स बन जाते हैं. Okay, so anything which is meaningful, I would definitely call it as a data. Okay, now the next slide is the source of data. So what are your sources of data? So when you think कि तुम्हें कोई data चाहिए किसी जगह से, so what all things would you do to get those kind of data? The first thing is interviews. So interviews is the very very traditional method. Okay, so let's speak about data warehouses. So when a data warehouse is built, the designer or the architects will need to understand what they want out of that data warehouse. they might have 10 things that they, that can be offered, but is not useful for the company. So the interviews are conducted. Interviews are conducted as such. What are your requirements? What do you want out of it? And then how is your source working? So source application hai, wo kis tarike se kaam kar raha hai? And what all information does it provide? So if you take consider all of these, you jot down some questions, then you get answers for those from the subject matter expert, or we call it as SMEs in the industry. Then the second good thing could be the surveys that you can have. Surveys as in any of these surveys that we have these days, probably any of the surveys. The best example for surveys nowadays is the Arogya Setu app. Okay, so you daily go and assess your health there. So that is a kind of survey that you are doing, and that data gets stored and is getting passed to some of the other information center. Okay, then third one is published article, social media. So social media is a big information, a big chunk of information. So there are different types of data which is shared. Apart from the text, there are images, there are GIFs, now there are avatars, there are videos, and then there are many other things. So there are different formats of data which is stored on the social media, and in the different format as well. Even if you talk about images, you will have JPEG, you will have PNG, you will have GIF, you will have this, you will have that. N number of formats you will see in this world. Okay. Then are the applications. Now, what do you mean by applications? This is the standard ERPs that is used in the organizations. So it if I speak about an insurance domain, so there will be one insurance application which basically works around all the systems. So the day when I inquire about a policy or say a policy plan, the whole things get recorded, and then these data gets updated according to the stages where I am from. Okay, so जैसे मैंने पॉलिसी के लिए मैंने आज policybazaar.com पे फोन किया. फोन करने के बाद में that person tells me about the plans, and then so that stays in the inquiry stage. Then once I'm happy with all those plans, all the things are okay with me, I agree to this. So it turns out to be in a placement format. Then जब मैंने उसका payment कर दिया, payment करने के बाद में that gets applied to me, or probably that gets issued to me. So the data are under the different stages are stored there. So again, the history of its journey is maintained right from the day I called the insurance company till I ask for any claim, or probably the policy gets matured or lapsed. Okay, so these all history is also maintained. Probably you have already learned these topics, or maybe you would learn these things in the coming years. So I'm talking about the databases things, more of the slowly changing dimensions, and these are more terminologies. I would not discuss these more in details, just to give you some flavor that tells about that the what all things that you read or learn today, those really exist in the industry. The applications are something which you might not be aware of. Okay, then moving towards the next source is the files. Excel files being the best example for these. You have some data in Excel, and then this is dumped to some other format or the usable format, and then the different devices. Now devices, what do you mean by devices? Probably it could be your phone, it could be any of your IoT device, it could be your car. So there is a huge volume of data which is generated. So consider an airplane. So when an airplane takes off from Mumbai to Delhi, the fractional journey for this would be an hour and a half. So in 90 minutes, there are so many sensors which are working in the flight, and all these sensors collects data. So by the time the flight takes off from Mumbai and lands to Delhi, within these 90 minutes, there are TBs and TBs of data which is generated. Now, how is this data useful? That data gets useful by, so we got to make this information all meaningful. So to make meaningful, you've got to have three things. First is the right platform. Second is the right data. And third is the right interface. So what do you mean by right platform? So right platform is, say, if you are collecting an insurance data, you should be having some platform under which you collect all those information. You store them in some format. You can store them in form of tables. You can store them in form of JSON, or maybe XML is something that you must be aware of. JSON is the newer format, but if you know this, well and great. This is the new data type that would be the new format of the data, I would say. And then the right interface. The right interface, what does it mean? It gives you some kind of visualization. All right. So moving on to what is data used for? So now, as my screen says, the data can be used for, say, ad making. Okay. Then decision making. Then to learn user habits. Can be used for sales and reporting. I missed the reporting word, but that's okay. Sales and reporting. And then could be machine learning, could be artificial intelligence, and could be IoT. IoT is Internet of Things. Okay, so what I'll do is, since you all know that how the data gets captured, calculated, moved here and there, how are facts and dimensions created, we would not discuss that much in detail, but we would restrict our sessions in discussing these topics. So how are ads useful? How does it help in decision making? So I'll try to bring up one case study for each of these topics so that you can relate things, how those things work. Okay. So from data and analytics. So these two words go hand in hand. Like my department is insight and data. So it again means the same thing. And data analytics again means out the same thing up here. So now if you see, there are different aspects to these things. So like the one we could see up here, the very familiar thing to you all would be, I believe, is IoT, AI, augmented reality, graphs analytics, data science. I'm not very sure if you would be aware of these, but again, making some meaningful information from data, that science is called data science. And the experience economy, I believe that the right side of the screen is something that you would not be familiar with, but again, I would not like to challenge that. I was in my college 10 years back and I really did not know these words. So I'm just assuming that these all would not be known to you. But again, if you know all these, well and good, you are way ahead of your time. And hyper-personalization, machine intelligence, behavior analytics, and journey science. So these are the different aspects for data and analytics. Okay. So life cycle of a data. So when we talk about a life cycle of data, the thing actually starts from generation. Pehle mere paas data honi chahiye, phir main uske upar kuch kaam kar paunga. Now how do you create your data? That we spoke about this in our sources content. So you can have multiple sources for these. We have spoken around that. So data generation is the first place, and then you finalize a method to collect it. Now collection again is a tedious task. You will have to identify how do you want to collect these data. Okay, you might need to go to an application and read to it. You might need to connect to a social media, and then you will probably need to collect it. You will have to identify the problem statement first, and accordingly you will have to generate a collection idea. Okay, the third one is the storage one. Storage here again relates to the storage mechanism. The hard drives and the SSDs these days are very cheap, so you can move to those platforms to store your data, or maybe you can move to clouds. Now cloud again is a different field, a very vast field these days, and much anticipated growth field. So if anybody of you would need any information about cloud computing, you can still get in touch with me. I can help you understand what all these things are. And probably we can have a different session for cloud computing. Okay, so storage is the another aspect that you move across. Once the data is stored, you have the hell amount of data, but you don't know what do you do out of it. Then you start making sense of those data by using some tools. There are some tools available in the market, or would say there are some models available in the market which can help you understand the data and can give you out results in forms of visualization. Now, why visualization? Say I give you a table which has got 100 records. And 100 records, this will have the students' marks or the students' percentage. So there are 100 students, and then there are the percentage of those students. But now I want a visualization chart. Probably I want to make out quickly that who is the first rank holder. Okay, so if I put it in a form of visualization or in a chart, it is much easier for me to identify. Ye graph upar dikh raha hai, probably this is the guy who has topped, or this is the one who has scored very less, or we can shade them out, we can color them out. So if there are anybody who has got less than say 60%, we can classify them into different colors. Okay. So these visualizations do help, and then based on these visualizations, we can run around some analysis. Okay, so that brings us to this analysis steps. This and the analysis from this would generate some kind of intelligence. Okay, then this intelligence, again, you understand that, okay, now I have got my the thing that I was looking for, probably who is the topper of the class. So I know that he or she is the topper of the class. Okay, visualization again is a very powerful tool by itself. Okay, so assume that if it had been a time where you were told that if you want to go to place X to place Y, and you are told go left and then right, then left, then right, and probably after 100 meters. But instead, when you have a Google map which visualizes you the way, it tells you in advance, or it can help you understand where you are going. So that again gives you a powerful thing in your hand. Okay. So how is data used now? Okay. So we'll come to again those same topics, ads. So YouTube Pay, these ads would be used as a source of income. Now, how these ads are generated? The kind of videos that you look. Okay, the videos, jis tarike se tum log dekhte jaoge, it tries to get the cookies. But again, the YouTube app on your phone, it does not only read the cookies from the app, rather it reads out the temporary location or the cookies location overall. So if you have been looking for an insurance for a long time, or you might have been searching for insurance for a long time, it is very what do you say, predictable that you might have an insurance ad on your phone while you're watching the next video. Okay. Then these AdSense comes into the picture. So there are a few videos into which you will see, aaj tum log usme ad dekh rahe ho, to ek particular ad hai. Then if you watch it after a month, then you will see another ad. Okay, so those are the AdSense. So ads are given. Now these ads again generate some incomes. So these all uses your cookies. So cookies again is a format, is a form of your data. So this is the data, how it is used, and give you some personalized results. And if not personalized results, at least try doing this. If you're watching any video and if there is an ad which is coming, it might prompt you for something, that why am I seeing this ad, or probably go to that option and then tell it that I do not want to watch this ad for any reason. The chances of you shown that advertise is reduced by chunk because that particular information is used. So that particular data gets highlighted up there. Okay. Moving on to the next topic is decision making. Decision making is for corporate decisions, cap service and telecom plan that we are talking about. So assume a scenario where you want to go from Dombivli to the airport. You try to book an Uber cab. Okay, then Uber cab, I'm specifically using the Uber, not Ola, because there is some knowledge to the Uber drivers. They would know where we want to go. Okay, I'm not very sure if Ola drivers know that before putting the OTP, if they know that where we are going. So I'll stick to the Uber example. You book a cab from Dombivli to airport, say during the morning time. Okay, and your cab gets cancelled. Then thode der ke baad mein you get pissed off and then you cannot do anything, but all you can do is book an another cab. That cab also gets cancelled. Then tumko gussa aa jata hai, bole ki nahi yaar ye kya ho raha hai, when you raise a complaint to the Uber one. So what Uber wala will do is, the person that you have complained or the customer care person would not really do that. He would pass on this complaint to his analytic team. Analytic team kya karega ki usko pata karega ki kya ho raha hai us area mein, kyun nahi liya ja raha hai. Then with respect to the huge data that they have about the passenger moving here and there, they would understand a pattern ki subah ke time pe ye cancel ho rahe hain, sham ke time pe cancel nahi ho rahe. So there could be some reason for it, and then they can probably come out with some out of box scenarios. So now subah ke time pe kyun cancel ho rahe hain and sham ke time pe kyun cancel nahi hote hain, iska pata karna padega. So hota kya, to unko pata chalta hai ki when the cab is booked in early morning, this cab driver goes to picks up the passenger, goes to the airport, and then there are no flights which are international flight landing in the morning time. So wo bichara phas gaya wahi pe, then 5-6 ghanta usko wahi rehna padta hai because there are no flights at that time. And then jab usko flight milta hai to hi wo bahar aa sakta hai. खाली कैब वो बाहर लाएगा तो उसको चार्जेस लेना पड़ेगा एयरपोर्ट का. सो दैट इज अ हिट ऑन हिज कॉस्ट. सो उसका प्रॉफिट कम हो जाता है. सो इसीलिए सुबह के टाइम पे वो अवॉइड करता है एयरपोर्ट जाने के लिए. पर अगर यही डोंबिवली से पवई तक का अगर लेंगे, दैट ड्राइवर टेक्स दैट ट्रिप. ओके, सो यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग द पॉइंट दैट सुबह के टाइम पे वो नहीं जा रहा. सो दीज आर द थिंग्स दैट दे अंडरस्टैंड. सो इस बेसिस पे प्रोबेबली उबर कैन डिस्काउंट द रेट्स कि सुबह के टाइम पे अगर कोई यहाँ पे आता है, एयरपोर्ट पे आता है, एंड द एयरपोर्ट चार्जेस जो भी है उबर ड्राइवर के लिए, दैट वुड बी लाइक हैप्पी आवर्स. दे कैन गिव 50% डिस्काउंट टू इट. सो वो 50% डिस्काउंट मिल जाएगा तो उसके चार्जेस कम हो जाएंगे, प्रॉफिट ड्राइवर के पास में ज्यादा रहेगा, एंड ही कैन ड्राइव यू फ्रॉम Dombivli टू एयरपोर्ट विदाउट एनी कैंसिलेशन. सो दैट इंक्रीजेस द कस्टमर एक्सपीरियंस. तो कस्टमर ने यहाँ से कैब बुक किया, आ गई कैब, सीधा चल गया, देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम एट ऑल. बट जब कैंसिलेशन आएगा तब वहां पे, तो इस टाइम पे डेटा काम आएगा, एंड दिस डेटा इज यूज्ड फॉर डिसीजन मेकिंग नाउ. सो इट इज नो मोर अ ट्रांजैक्शनल इंफॉर्मेशन. यहां से गया, यहां से आया, यहां से गया, यहां से गया, क्या फर्क पड़ा, कुछ नहीं. बट देन यू नो दीज थिंग्स. देन नेक्स्ट वी कैन प्रोबेबली टॉक अबाउट अ टेलीकॉम प्लान. सो जियो तो अभी सब लोग की बैंड बजा ही रहा है. Okay, so let's talk about Jio. That Jio wanted to come into the market and wanted to understand the understand ki hum kaun sa plan launch kare jisme hum log successful rahenge. So before that they would need some information, some data about it. So they got some data from somewhere, probably from the parent company, the Reliance India Mobile, which was a part of Anil Ambani. Now that company, I don't know where it is. So those telecom plan, so those data can be used. So because of that, they know that public these days need more of data. They do not call much, they do not talk much, but they need something in their hand which is more or less seamlessly connected to the internet. So they will learn the user habits and this and other stuffs. So they will understand that if I launch this particular plan, so if I give a 99 rupees plan in which I give 1,000 calls free and 1 GB data free every day, the users are more than happy for it. Okay. Now, these are the things that also make you take some additional decisions. Like I would assume that Jio came in 2017 or 2016. I do not really remember. But during those days, when Jio started giving 1 GB free data, other company used to charge rupees 250 or 300 for 1 GB per month. So the consumption of data, was 1 GB per month during that time, and it would cost you roughly rupees 250 to 300 rupees per month. But now Jio, at the same cost, it is giving you 30 times of the data. Okay, so it is giving you 1 GB data per day. Now what happens with this? It is allowed to get more and more information about you as well. So wo tumko data jyada use karne ke liye de raha hai, but at the same time wo tumse data bhi collect karte ja raha hai. So and because Jio knows that this data that he collects is a gold, he can use it very wisely. And now if you recently have addressed or say you have attended any of the Reliance AGM of 2020, you would have seen that that they are giving out a lot many services apart from what the industry expects. Okay, then moving to the next point is recommendations and user habits. So Google Now is my favorite example up here. So recommendations. So you, so all those who are using Android phones probably can relate this. iPhone ones, I don't know. Okay, so Google Now is a place where I regularly read my news. So when I read some more news, it probably asks me if you want more news or less news about these things. And accordingly, I can select those things. And based on that, it understands my habits. It understands that I am more interested in sports. I'm not interested in politics. Probably you can give me some business information and some other informations, like page three informations also. So according to that, that data is used to understand my habit. And accordingly, it can recommend me something. Okay, then the sales one is the most common one. If you have bought a TV from Amazon, if you got a mobile from Amazon, then probably it is very high chance that you might be getting an promotional ad or a promotional email or discounts for a washing machine. कि ये आदमी ने हमसे टीवी लिया है, वॉशिंग मशीन टीवी लिया है, मोबाइल फोन लिया है, probably हम try करके देखते हैं वॉशिंग मशीन लेगा क्या. And sir, only for you, rupees 1500 discount. Use this coupon code. Okay, so this data can be also used for your increase in sale and understanding the pattern of sales. Okay, from sales, I can also think of one example that with a pattern of sales that I have in Big Bazaar, I understand that जो भी आदमी यहाँ पे आता है, ब्रेड लेता है, वो बटर भी लेके जाता है. So I understand that these are my data patterns. So if there is a customer who is buying bread, he also buys butter. What I can do is I can give them a discount of 1 rupee or 2 rupee, whatever the decision I call it for. But I can give it out a discussion. Okay, चलो discount नहीं देते हम लोग. But at least in my store, I can try to keep it closer. So जहां पर ब्रेड है उसके आसपास में ही बटर रख दूंगा, सो दैट द कस्टमर डज नॉट ट्रेवल फ्रॉम वन कॉर्नर टू अनदर कॉर्नर. ओके, सो दोज आर द टाइप ऑफ डेटा विच आर एनालाइज्ड एंड वर्कड अपॉन. ओके, सो दैट गिव्स यू सम काइंड ऑफ सेल्स इंफॉर्मेशन. नाउ कमिंग डाउन टू द एडवांस टॉपिक दैट वी हैव, सो दीज आर फील्ड बाई देमसेल्फ. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट मशीन लर्निंग. So machine learning, understand a scenario where you have Google Photos app installed on your phone. Okay, so it tries to read all the images and then it tries to detect the faces. Okay, on the basis of faces, it creates virtual albums. So you can have a dedicated folder within which will have only your photo, but not just your photo, all the photos in which you are there. Okay, so this is a face detection or the image processing technique that is used up here. So this basically helps the machine to learn more and more. Now Google has some higher plans. They have some advanced plans, but they need data. So what they will tell you, tum Google Photos pe sare photos upload kar do, and we will give you unlimited storage. And that gives you a lot of protection. Ke kal tumhara phone kharab ho gaya to tumko kuch tumhara koi photos loss nahi hone wale. So it is all safe and secure with me. But all it asks you is for some data. So these are the photos that is actually a data for Google. Now they use these photos to train their machines, to train their machine models actually. So this is how you call person X and person Y as a different person. And these are the two photos in which you are standing onto a different angle. Because of that different angle, you are still okay. So you have person X and you have person Y, and you want to compare all these two people. So you can use some kind of processing, some kind of machine learning. So because of this, you have two photos which help them understand that these two are different entities or the same entity. As understand the thing that if you have this data in millions and billions, how strong would the machine be to identify if that person is the right person or not? Okay, now in some sci-fi movies you must have seen this, that they have hacked some CCTV cameras, and according to all the cameras they have given one photo, and all of a sudden ek CCTV camera achanak se jaagta bolta re, I have seen this person in New York and at this particular street, and you send out your agents to trace them. So okay, so this is the process where machine learns to understand people and then give out some results to it. So now machine learning sirf ye Google Photos ke liye nahi use hota hai, it is used for many other things. Google Photos is one of those applications. Then Google Photos mein ek feature aur hai ki you can ask him to create a video for it based on this particular photo. So you can actually do that. So this is how the machine learns up here. And then artificial intelligence. What is artificial intelligence at the first thing? You have some data, you have a machine, and then this data is fed to this machine, and this machine keeps learning. And at the point, this machine gets expert enough. Okay, so as soon as this machine gets expert enough, it generates its own intelligence. So these kind of intelligence, I would treat it as artificial intelligence. And the best example up here is Google Assistant. I'm not an huge fan of any of these products that I'm trying to say, because they all are great in their own aspect. But again, I'm trying to use more Google app examples, because that is something that you would relate day in day out. So you say to your Google Assistant, hey Google, please set an alarm of 5 o'clock, and it would listen to you and set an alarm for 5 o'clock. So this is how did this happen? This happened through first machine language. They heard your voice, they understood that this is the style by which you say, hey Google, and this is an analog graph, and it would plot its own graph to understand that this means hello. And it would not only learn the word hello from you, it would read from 1000 people, for example. So 1000 people says hello, and then the data science comes into picture, wherein histograms and data graphs or everything are generated, and according to which by which it understands that okay, 90% of the people says in this tone, this language, this accent, the word hello, and rest have some deviation. So probably it will try to bring up some probability. Okay, this is a set of my data in which means hello for it. So the Google Assistant is the best example of artificial intelligence. You must have, this is at a very primary stage. So it is not very useful in India as of now, but in US or UK, it is very much useful. So probably you can ask your Google Assistant to book a restaurant or probably book a flight ticket for you. So all you got to do is give your Google Assistant some information. Okay, so how does it do it? उस Google Assistant से ये काम करीबन हजारों करोड़ों बार करवाया रहेगा, and based on it, it is given some feedback based on if it is correct or wrong. Okay, so it has learned from it. It has learned from your information. It has learned from the machine. So machine learning. And then it moves out to the artificial intelligence. So if you understand that these two fields are connected, you are very correct. And these two fields would go hand in hand. So the machine has to learn first, and then it will bring it to your own intelligence. Now, machine learning and intelligence. So consider a newborn baby. Usko hum log usko chalna seekhne ke liye kareeban 9 se 10 mahine lag jata hai. And then probably to speak some words. Next 6 to 7 months, and dheere dheere they learn it. So you teach them today, tomorrow they might forget. बाद में हम फिर से उसको सिखाते हैं, फिर से भूल जाते हैं, फिर से सिखाते हैं. Then one fine day they understand everything. The good thing with machine is they do not forget because memory. They have the power of memory. So the growth जो है कि एक baby को हम लोग जो सिखाते हैं उसमें हम लोग को शायद 3 साल लगे, मशीन को शायद 1 महीने में काम हो जाए. एंड देन द बिगेस्ट एडवांटेज टू दिस इज जब यहाँ पे नेक्स्ट बेबी होता है तो उसे फिर से उसी साइकिल से जाना पड़ता है. बट इफ देयर इज अ न्यू प्रोडक्ट, वी कैन ग्रैब दिस इंफॉर्मेशन, वी कैन ग्रैब दिस डेटा एंड फीड इट टू इट. सो दिस ऑटोमेटिकली व्हाट यू कैन से इनहेरिट्स द इंटेलिजेंस. ओके, सो you understand that the data is not just an Excel or an ERP system. It can be used for, it is used for many of those things. And the most artificial level of intelligence, I would say, is the IoT. It is a place where the devices talk to each other. Okay, there is no human intervention. So you have given all the knowledge, you have given all the machine learning, artificial intelligence to something, and then those devices work by their own. So consider an example of Tesla. So Tesla is an auto driving car. So isko aap log ne road pe chhod diya hai. Road pe chhodne ke baad mein it drives it, and then sensors se information lete ja raha hai. Here again the data is dynamic, it is not the pre-calculated one, but iska jo computation hai usko bahut strong banaya gaya hai, because it should be able to understand all those information thoroughly. ओके, सो जब ड्राइव चल रहा है, जब गाड़ी चल रही है उसकी, तो उस टाइम पर इट इज ट्राइंग टू सेंस ऑल ऑफ दिस कि मेरे पीछे कौन आ रहा है, मेरे पास कौन आ रहा है, आगे रास्ता कैसा है. इट कैन ऑल्सो यूज गूगल मैप्स, इट कैन ऑल्सो यूज ए कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ मल्टीपल टेक्नोलॉजीज. ओके, सो दीज ऑल थिंग्स वुड अगेन एक्ट इन अ इकोसिस्टम. अभी इकोसिस्टम की बात करते तो टेस्ला में द फेलियर्स आर बिकॉज देयर आर ह्यूमन ड्राइवर्स. 2 रुपए की गाड़ी चल रही है, or there are some reckless drivers, or probably there is a driver who is sick and did not react to the road, or probably we human beings are not ideal. We do not live in the ideal world. We usually call it as ideally aisa hona chahiye, but we do not live in the ideal world. But for machines, we can make it ideal when there is an ecosystem for it. There are 10 devices on, and there are 10 cars, and those are all 10 Tesla cars. So those 10 cars can talk to each other. And जैसे वो कार पास में आ रही, दिस कार विल टेल दैट कार कि मैं तेरे पास में आ रही हूँ, मैं तेरे देखो तुझे ओवरटेक करके जाऊंगी और जाऊंगा, बट सो टेक केयर ऑफ इट. एंड दिस कार एक्नॉलेजेस दैट थिंग. सो IoT, सो इंटरनेट ऑफ थिंग्स. नाउ टू कम्युनिकेट विद ऑल दीज डिवाइसेस, इंडिया हैज ऑल्सो लॉन्च द न्यू सेट ऑफ सिम कार्ड्स विच वुड बी हैविंग अ 13-digit number. सो इफ यू हैव योर कार which has got a GPS locator input, try to understand that it has got some SIM card, which is a 13 digit SIM card. Okay, so that is something where the data is captured, calculated, used, and thrown away. Okay, so these are the different case study that I wanted to discuss with you all. Hope this was useful. And I'm sure there are many applications to this, but because of the time limitations and stuff like these, I could only bring up to these. So ads, decision making, recommendation, sales, machine learning, artificial intelligence, IoT. I believe these examples are enough for you to understand how important the data is, what is the overall journey. So data collection and all, leave that you will study in your syllabus. But what is eventually the picture around these? So this is something which is which I'm called for actually. Okay. So any questions and answers that you have, we can discuss this. Over to you, committee team.
Yeah, thank you so much, Mr. Abhishek Sarda. It was amazing.
Abhishek bolo yaar, sir.
Sorry. It was an amazing session. So you talked about how data is used in the industry. So I don't have any questions in specific.
Okay.
So if anyone else has any questions, please feel free to ask. I think
no. Either my session is 100% clear or probably people slept down in between.
No.
Actually, your session was crystal clear, and I came quite late, but I enjoyed the session. Actually, it was great to know the insights, how is the data used, and where and how the companies exactly use. And next time, whenever are you going? If someone is starting a startup, how can utilize all these things? It was interesting to listen all this.
Yes, a good example that you raised up now is the startup thing. So if there is a new startup, how do they start with that thing? So they have got their some own data, some own information by which they would be able to communicate. Or probably they will be able to take some decisions like the Swiggy thing. So they go to each and every hotel, restaurants, they talk to them, generate some data, put it to us. And then based on us, we give them some ratings or something. So these and again are some kind of data. So you have a data about a data. We usually call it as a metadata.
Yeah. It was great to listen. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, it was very different take on data science and machine learning and all of it. We usually don't study about the applications much. We just study the tools and techniques. But this is great. I mean, we other students who are trying to learn about this would be more encouraged after learning all this.
I hope that adds some value to it.
Yes, of course, definitely. Thank you so much.